Hello and welcome. In this tutorial, we are going to create a simple road with Trian 3D Builder. The tutorial is divided in four sections. In the first one, we will go through a fast road creation workflow. Then, we will see the dedicated road menus. In the third section, we'll take a look to the parts that conform a road. And finally, we will perform some basic road editing. The goal is to explain the concepts that will allow us to get more sophisticated road configurations in further tutorials. Open Trian 3D Builder, add a grid, set the projection on grid, and apply. In the Data tab, select the Vector Data menu. Click on Create Bezier, and in the Vector list, select the Two Lanes and Sidewalk group. Draw your road on the viewport. Now we are going to use the WYSIWYG mode, and there is where the magic comes. Click on View, Show High Vector, WYSIWYG Show Selected Vectors. From now up, F6. Press it, and we have just created a road. After creating a road, some things have changed in the vector data menu. In the vector tree, we have a new vector group with separators. We have also a lane edit menu and a new modifier, the profiler HD. These menus, in conjunction with the road WYSIWYG tools and the roads dropdown on the main bar, will allow us to edit our roads. In Trian 3D Builder, a road consists of a center line, separators, and polynomials. The center line is the mother of all lanes in that road. It's the zero lane in the lane edit menu and corresponds to the bezier we have previously drawn. It can be edited as any bezier, you can add points or smooth it by adding subdivision steps. It has a profiler HD attached to it, and there you can change some attributes like road type, height, or marking type. Then we have the separators. Each of them corresponds to a lane, and each one has its own profiler modifier. They allow us to change the lane textures, marking types, or attributes like speed limit. In this case, we have 6 separators, therefore we have 6 lanes. The colors assigned to each of the lanes on the lane edit menu tell us the type of that particular lane. Yellow is used for sidewalks. Brown is used for curb, gray is used for driving lanes, and white is our center line. To change the type of lane, just click on the Type drop-down menu in its profiler modifier. As you see, there is a big choice of lane types. To add a lane, just press on the plus button on the lane edit menu. To erase a lane, select it and press the red cross. The polynomials are the bezels contained between 2 points of a separator. Polynomials allow us to edit the shape of the lanes. In the polynomial edit menu is where we change the width of the polynomials. If no points were added, it will change the width for the whole lane. Let's perform some editing. First of all, press F6. You need to be in WYSIWYG mode in order to edit the lanes. We are gonna edit the center line. We are gonna change its marking to broken. Don't forget to use local overrides. Now, let's change the texture for the sidewalk. We see like the height of the sidewalk and the curb is different to the one of the road, and that's what makes that step. Let's change also the material for the curb. Now let's change the material for the other curb too. Let's make that sidewalk broader, maybe 3 meters or 2. And we change the material to that one too, to that sidewalk. Now let's tweak the polynomials. I'm gonna add some points to the driving lane. I will go to point selection mode so I can see them, and I will add two more. Now I'm gonna select the middle point so I can translate them with the translation tool. And that's it. I think that's a good example about how to deal with polynomials. That's all for this tutorial. See you next time.